I'm gonna take this
to this.
Ooh. All right, hello. We are here today with our friend Sheldon, otherwise known as
Tynomi Banks,
who is an amazing drag queen in Toronto and
epic drag queen. Been so blessed.
I'm actually Toronto superstar.
Exactly. So we thought we would get a little lesson about some drag makeup,
and we're gonna try and become drag queens.
Ooh. Yeah, it's gonna be so fun. So we took a shower, shaved the armpits.
Properly.
Let's block eyebrows. I did this when I was a little twink back in my day.
So you don't block your eyebrows anymore?
Not anymore. I'm a big woman now. Because for white people, I don't know why everything has to show up through your makeup. So you have to create a dark base, like my cocoa skin right here. My nice cocoa skin. I don't need no correction.
That is so weird. So you're literally just putting glue on his eyes.
Yeah, like, but they go back and forth.
Mm-hmm. To like really so like fill it.
And what is the point of this?
Well, you want your brows to be down so that you don't have
what does down mean?
Like stuck to your skin, so then when you put makeup on it, it looks like it's just skin.
Yeah.
What?
What she said.
But isn't like thick eyebrows and like Cara Delevingne?
I don't know who she is. See, let this dry a little bit.
Yeah, and then put the powder on.
And then do one more coat of that.
Okay. Look at my eyebrows. All
right. When I got into drag, I was really like afraid that my skin would break out. I used to have bad skin in high school because I felt like there's so many different type of oils and stuff in the products.
Did you ever break out at first or no?
No. So some of the drag queens, what they usually do, they leave a little bit of hair in the corner to make it look natural. So like—
Oh, so you have the real hair first.
Yeah, they have your hair first. Mm-hmm. Oh. But Shea Quiley, I love how she does hers. She only blocks up half the eyebrow and leaves the hair. Okay. It's called the ombre look. I do block my eyebrows because it gives me just a lot of space to do everything. I use like a really dull knife and I go like this through it. I know, sorry.
And I cut my face.
Yeah, then I cut it open and I shave it up. And I go through it like this. Hmm. And it dries so fast. This 17 layer is literally—
Yeah, I'm like, this is already a lot.
This is the budget version.
Do you want to try your other eye?
Yes.
Go in. Like back and forth.
Yeah, but the whole eyebrow. Like get a lot, really get it in there.
Yeah. All right. And then you're gonna take this wand.
Wow. It's like, how does this not make it break out?
Honey. And you're gonna take it down here and then comb all of it. The reason why we comb it up is to help to give—
Give you a facelift?
Yeah, facelift.
Wow, I've never looked at my eyebrows like this. Like eyebrows are so weird.
You're doing very well.
Do you go like, if you're alone, you go—
I don't do this. Right?
Is that banana powder?
Yeah.
I love that that's what it's
called. When you put it on, you're gonna like pat and up, like in the same direction. Yeah, this is perfect.
It's coming.
Oh no, this is great.
Yeah. What was the first time you did drag?
My first
time
ever?
did you go out or did you just like put makeup on a little bit?
No, I got someone to do it. Her name was Nicolette Brown. And I went out as say, but I look like Tina Turner. It was Halloween.
Fun. Oh, Halloween. Okay.
It was at Woody's. It was Halloween.
How old were you?
I must have been 22.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah. I felt like powerful. I felt super sexy. You feel really pretty. And then when you are pretty, and then people come over and be like, hey.
You're so pretty.
Like, I know I had a boyfriend, but I would have sucked her dick. Just so you guys know. I must have started actually doing performing, like, 2 years after that.
Oh wow, okay. Yeah,
I didn't want to do it because I was getting judged, for sure. Obviously, it changed dramatically, but like back then, it was a lot.
Before we finish today, you also have to help us come up with drag names.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so that's gotta be on our mind.
Busted Bertha, that'll be mine.
Okay.
What I've learned, girls, white girls, white boy girls. Yeah. Your hair, so like when you shave and everything, you sometimes have a blue.
Little or
yeah, you could see it through this. You know that it's down though, but like if you do this, this cancels out that blue tone that your eyebrows are.
Because you're about to cover this up with.
Yeah, because then you want this to look like skin, right?
So
like,
what you're gonna do.
How do I look? Do I look like a normal Cheeto boy?
You're gonna just lightly put this
on top of it, okay.
And then
start covering it.
And then cover it again. Okay. Guys, this video, he looks shambles, but trust me. Because we're slaves here in Toronto, end up doing almost 20 something songs a night. And I change at least four to five times.
We have to put these on now because we have raggedy hair. Because
we're working at McDonald's. Like this.
Okay. Okay.
What?
Where are you going though? Are you going to 50 Cent's club?
Like, put it back so you can put still makeup on your face.
I feel like I've never seen myself so ugly.
So you're gonna do what I like to do is like kind of draw. So I draw here in lines like this. So right now for you both of you guys, when you be light on your eyebrows,
okay.
So like not to disturb them, just like kind of like, you know, scratch the surface.
How much money do you spend on makeup? Like, I mean, that's a big question.
A starter kit, I would say bring at least $600 to start.
Whoa.
To just
to go from zero to enough.
Like at least like a smoky eye.
So how many years have you been doing drag?
12 years.
So have you noticed a change due to RuPaul's Drag Race and everything?
It came out and it made a bridge for, I guess, the straight or straight brothers and sisters, and which is amazing.
Yeah.
But then it also created diehard fans that think they know what it is to be a drag.
Like what it takes, yeah.
Right. Yeah, crazy.
What is this?
Yes, Beauty Blender. I use different sides to it, so like, because we're gonna do all over, I'll just use like the bigger part. You wet it a little bit, I find the product smooths out way better with it.
Make me flawless.
Do you remember the first time you saw Tynomi Banks perform? I just remember the one time that he tried to pull me in.
Tell that story.
She was just confident on stage and she kept saying, Harry Potter, come on stage. If I were to go on stage, I would have to take off my pants.
He's so cute. I had a little crush. I'm like, Harry Potter, come on stage.
Because you put on like a whole performance, like you're a dancer, you do your little singing riffs in between, like you lip sync perfectly, like you had costume changes, it was everything.
Sometimes drag queens don't know the words.
Yeah.
Our only job is to know the words. Sometimes they just don't know the words. Usually, to apply this, queens use like a foundation brush. Right here where the middle of the ear is.
Okay, so you go to like
this
above
that your temple? This is your temple.
Yeah, just
so just right here. And this product, I'm not very used to. The same beauty blender that I used for all over, I'm gonna use it in these parts as well. Look at that, diffusion.
Wow.
Yes, bitch, oh my God. That's really cute, actually. For drag queens, what we do, we create like a whole hairline. This is to help make your face feminine. Because girls have small heads,
right,
small
like
faces.
Not, like
what you
want to
do is soften your features. So what we do, go here, going real nice. But what you want to do is like a triangle motion. So now we're gonna set it.
Okay.
Meaning we don't want nothing to move.
Color?
This is what we call by beat.
So okay. Beat. Just literally beat the camera.
Yeah. Do the light parts first.
Okay.
And then go to the dark. And go off, guys. Makeup for me, I always feel like I look crazy and ugly in the beginning. I'm gonna go. Yeah, you see, that's the beating noise.
Feels good.
How did you make that noise?
She's beating in her face. One song I love to perform is, I think it's her name, SZA.
SZA,
The Weeknd.
Yeah, oh my God.
Oh, I wear like a little lingerie piece.
Oh my God, that's so
good. You got a girl, say you want me. You're gonna take some of this. This is my own personal thing. It's called fixing powder, weatherproof. To me, that means rain shine, tundra, blackout. I'm gonna use this loose powder for everything. For you,
I can try.
For you, because you have this beard, I almost want to go kind of dramatic with you.
Yeah, fuck me up.
So guys,
what's next?
I don't know, but you guys have to draw your own eyebrows. This brush is amazing.
Sorry.
Right where your eyebrow is, actually, those are good.
Those are starting points.
Guidelines. So like at the bottom, I dot it. I follow my nose like this. I dot it like that. So there's one dot. And then I turn. You see how this is all following my natural eyebrow?
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of want to just do the same thing, but just above. And then that's the end.
That's where he finishes?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, and now just try and like kind of finish. Okay, we're gonna try.
Don't worry, with makeup you could always go back and erase.
Okay.
How?
Do you just put like...
Stop squinting your eyes.
Is it like foundation over top to cover it or whatever?
Or because this is just powder.
You just like brush it off.
Yeah, brush it off.
Mine are a little evil, but I like it.
You were not supposed to fill them in, but I'm happy.
Oh, shit.
Your eyebrows on girls, like these girls, here is like lighter and then darker. Okay. So like, you wanted to make
it's like a gradient.
Yeah, right? So I'll do here darker.
Mm-hmm. So like pressing hard or just like using more of
it. Yeah, using more there. And already it's like I didn't diffuse it here. Yeah. I like that you did them like this.
They're so bushy. But they're cute.
I like them. This is the trick. Where you want the makeup to be on the most, that's where you start. We want your eyes to look more girly. I find you go outside. So when you put the product on, start right here. Just go halfway and then try to connect these two.
Okay.
We're gonna add some color.
Yay!
What color should I add to this freaky, beastly woman that I make?
Oh, and nice. It's like so.
It sticks to it. And
yeah,
then...
it's so pretty. This is such a nice eye.
Yeah, that's so nice.
I'm adding like a color on top of the brown.
Do you want to green?
Do you want to do green?
Yeah, something like gross.
Okay. Do you want to be like a little bit emo?
I'm picturing like.
Okay, so I'll
Grimes, Evanescence.
I'm picturing Grimes, Evanescence.
Is this what that powder's there to help? So later we just brush it off because there's like a bit of fallout of the eyeshadow on my cheeks, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So do you just kind of like leave it until you're
ready? I leave it. Do you guys feel old enough to do this?
To do what?
So.
Oh, I'm willing to try.
What I did for my first time because I was afraid because I had a black pencil, I mapped it out. Yeah. So I go like this right at the lid and then I go up.
This is where it gets hard though because like if I fuck this up, it's like. Yeah, game over?
No, not game
like
over, but...
what would you do if you like sneeze like
this? The foundation, go over it again.
Why not? And then try and build on
top
of that.
Yeah, but like,
just don't mess up? Okay, no pressure.
What was like the first show you brought like family or friends to? Like, did you practice first and then...
Oh yeah,
like...
it was my first time ever getting a big gig at Dundas Square. I was one of the first drag queens to perform there.
Oh wow.
And my mom came and the first thing she said to me was like, do you have any clothes?
How many what?
Do you have clothes to put on? I had a shirt, and I called it a dress. And she's like, it's not. It's not. All right, so now what we're gonna do, boys and girls, everything seems to be good. Just to
wipe everything away?
Yeah. Here, let me just do this. Smile. Go like this. Or actually do this. Like a fake one. Yeah. So I go right there where the balls are, and then wipe it back. There we go. And this is just on top of the contour. There we go.
Yeah, ooh, that's good.
Look at you, cutie. I'm gonna put the glue on the lash first.
Okay.
I kind of go like this. Don't bend them too much,
but
like
to that. To give them a bit of a curve.
Yeah, because obviously our eyes have a curve on them, right? So I kind of just do that a little bit and then put the glue on that.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna need you.
Oh my gosh, it's scary.
You can even cut these in half. Like start from the middle.
Like halfway.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. You didn't put any glue on.
Great.
Is this cool?
I'm trying to be...
He's trying to be edgy.
It's so cool, Greg.
Yeah, are you really doing this for
real?
You have barely any lips, so...
Okay.
I heard of a thing called overdrawing them.
I'm gonna overdraw the top.
You can keep them petite, but like, I'd follow the line of your lip. There's a natural lip line. And I'll just do that. Your lip is real
black.
Juicy. Yeah, they're black. You have black people's lips, so.
Oh no, I meant I want them to be black.
I would just do a darker lip.
Okay.
Ooh, yeah, you are like a space queen.
Look at you.
Wait, how do you put on wigs?
Yeah, usually these wigs, depending on what brand.
We don't have very good wigs.
So they got them from shambles.com. Usually they come with gauges, right?
What does that mean? You can clip it tighter?
Yeah, make it tighter or looser, like that. Where that hook is.
Oh, wow.
There we go. You have a big head?
Yeah.
So should we even do that? Because of your makeup, I make sure this touches the top of the
right,
head.
To not, you know it's
and then,
not gonna...
And then bring it back. Is it on your head? Because I see your white cap. Look at you. You're into your fantasy. Catherine McPhee, maybe?
Oh, yeah. Yes. Yeah. American Idol.
Yeah.
Catherine... McMee?
Yeah. Catherine McMee? Catherine McMee, get away from me.
I feel like my name's Beatrice.
Your
last name.
Oh, Beatrice Baxter.
Beatrice Baxter?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ooh.
I'm Beatrice Baxter.
And I'm Catherine McMee.
Oh my God. gosh, that was so much fun, guys. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Where can people find you? Shelly Mack, Instagram.
My Instagram is Shelly Mack, S-H-E-L-Y-M-A-C, or hashtag Tynomi Banks. Tynomi. It doesn't mean it's like that. It's Ty, T-Y-N-O-M-I.
Well, thank you guys for following us on this little drag journey. Thank you so much for coming.
You're very stunning. I love it.
We'll see you all next time.
Outro.